the center of attention. Who is that? Whispered Thomas to Duck. That, said Duck proudly, is a celebrity. A what? Asked Percy. A celebrity is a very famous engine, replied Duck. The driver says we can talk to him soon. Oh, said Duck. He's probably too famous to even notice us. Just then Gordon arrived. Said Gordon. Who cares? A lot of fuss about nothing but grass beating. He steamed away. Later that night, the engines found that the visitor wasn't conceited at all. He enjoyed talking to the other engines until long after the stars came out. He left early next morning. Gordon was still complaining. Good riddance, he grumbled, chattering all night. Who is he anyway? Duck told you, replied Thomas. He's famous. As famous as me? Nonsense. He's famouser than you. He went 100 miles an hour before you were even thought of. Huh, so he said, laughed Gordon. But I didn't like his looks. He's got no dome. Never trust domeless engines. They're not respectable. I never boast, but I'd say 100 miles an hour would be easier for me. Goodbye. Duck took some freight cars to Edmund Station. Hello, called Edmund. That famous engine came through this morning. He whistled to me. Wasn't he kind? He's the finest engine in the world, replied Duck. Then he told Edmund what Gordon had said. Take no notice, Edmund. He's just jealous. He thinks no engine should be famous but him. Look, he's coming now. Gordon was running very fast. His wheels pounded the rail. He did it, I'll do it. He did it, I'll do it. Gordon's train rocketed past and was gone. He'll knock himself to bits, chuckled Duck. Gordon's driver eased him off. Steady, Gordon. We aren't running a race. We are, then.
Somewhere behind them. They aren't respectable.